Welcome, Ramona.
Thank you.
So what inspired you to put your name forward as a candidate in this election?
Well, I've been the chief crown prosecutor in Medicine Hat for almost 20 years. Well, prosecutor for almost 20 years, chief for about 12, since 2009. And I was sort of coming to the point in my career where I had an opportunity to be promoted into a different role in management. So I would no longer be prosecuting people day to day in Medicine Hat. But I really thought I've so enjoyed being part of the community, being part of the justice system, and contributing to the safety of the community that I thought I've got more in the tank here. I can give other things to the community in another way. And I think that when I started to see sort of the list of candidates come out, and I thought kind of a skill set that I think could be valuable. And I hope that's what the voters think. That's certainly what I think, certainly my decision-making ability, my research skills, all of those things I thought would make me a good candidate for city council. So I thought, with the encouragement of my friend and family, I have two children, they're 8. They said, "You do it, Mama." So here I am.
Excellent. So you spoke a bit about your experience, but what experience will assist you in being an effective elected representative?
Sure. Well, I think, first of all, I have an ability to ask questions when I'm not sure. So I do get, in my work for years, report after report after report. And of course, that takes a lot of reading to keep on top of all the information you get. I certainly see just online hints of what council gets. I'm sure there's a lot more behind the curtain that I don't get to see just by a regular person looking online. So I think that desire to read, be fully informed, and to ask questions. And I think the other thing that people don't know about me is that, yeah, I've been in the courtroom and asked lots of questions there, but I'm also responsible for a budget. So I manage one of the larger law firms, if you consider the Crown a law firm, which I do. And so that has a budget, that has forecasting, that has HR requirements. So I'm quite familiar with all of those things. And I think a counselor has to be pretty well-rounded in all of that to be successful.
Great. So what do you believe are the important issues that are facing our region?
Economically. So I try to look at everything in the simplest terms I can, because it helps me understand when it's really complicated concepts. So really, in the past few years, Medicine Hat is like a two-income household in a way that lost half of an income. So like any other household budget, you have to make tough choices. You have to increase your income, or you have to decrease your expenses, because you have to meet that budget. And so I think what we've seen when you look at the statistics and our debt to income ratio, that a really big concern is that the city is spending more than we have. So we have to be like any household in that situation and say, how are we going to manage this budget and make those tough choices? But we still want to have a quality of life. We still want to take care of those that need our help. So it's complicated, completely doable. Completely doable. But that is the goal of council, I think. That's the biggest problem. And I think the risk here is that Medicine Hat has reserves. So it would be very tempting for council, especially if there's new councillors elected, to take this 4 years and say, we'll just keep using the reserves. But all that we're doing is deferring a bigger problem and making it next council's problem and future generations' problem. So this council has to work hard now to fix this dilemma that we're in. And it's nobody's fault. But we got to fix it.
So how do you believe your election platform will benefit and improve the lives of our constituents here?
I have a lot of things in my election platform. I'm very interested in social justice programs. I'm interested in helping people with addictions, homelessness, mental health. Those things are very important. I think that says who we are as a city when the city contributes to those things. When other taxpayers say to city council, these things are important to us. So I think that's part of my platform. But a bigger part of my platform is that the first thing that certainly I've listed in my platform is we have to make low risk economic decisions. Because I think there's a tendency, at least in my opinion, for what it's worth, hopefully voters agree with me about this, is that we're always trying to hit the economic home run, because we have done that in the past. We're sort of like that superstar team that we can hit home run whenever we want it. Well, we're not hitting a home run anymore. But there's other ways to develop economically other than just swinging for that, you know, company that's going to sweep in and give us 1,000 jobs. I think there's better ways to do it than just always trying to hit that home run.
Great. So what strategies and specific policies would you suggest that would address the pillars in the Chamber's Vote Prosperity platform? So those include innovation and a competitive strategy, infrastructure development, image and branding, workforce development, as well as business and financial supports.
All good things. Thank you, Chamber, for writing them down for me. Oh, I love it. So innovation and competitive strategy. I think that we've done a lot of work in that. But again, I want to just take it back to say that small business is the foundation here. I think a lot of counselors have probably said that to you. There's a lot of counselors who are businessmen who believe that. I believe it. My dad was a small business owner. I've unloaded a lot of hardware from trucks before, counted a lot of nails. I know that I would like to know and work with small businesses to say, rather than trying to bring in that new company that has 500 jobs, let's find 100 local companies who want to expand and increase their workforce by 5 jobs, 10 jobs, 15 jobs. And I think there's lots of ways of doing that we haven't fully explored. I think the city can help with online, people who want to move part of their business into an online format so they can take the goods they're producing that everyone in Medicinet loves to eat or use or whatever, and to get them shipped out. I think that there's a lot of businesses that have, there's a few I'm thinking of, that's such a great business model, like making homemade meals for people who are busy. You know, like, I'm busy and I like it when someone else cooks for me, but maybe I don't have anyone to cook for me, so I've got to do it. So, and I see them on Facebook. Well, what if those businesses, those home, like just building up, could have access to city grants to build their websites, to get more people to know that they're out there and to use their services? So I'm all for pushing competitively to get big companies into Medicine Hat. But I want to do that with low risk and not spend a lot of city money to do it. I would rather look at the businesses that are in the city and say, hey, you want to grow? Here's how the city can help you do that.
Excellent. So, Ramona, do you have any final thoughts, concluding comments, or words that you'd like to share with the voting public?
Yeah, I think it's important that people know that the city has responsibilities with the taxpayer dollars. And I'm sure lots of people had talked about this and how critically important it is that we're very careful with it and what we spend money on. And so that's got to be a focus. I've talked about that a lot, but I don't want people to forget that the things that make us Medicine Hat are recreational facilities, are, you know, parks, all of those things that we use on a daily basis, and the programs we have for people who need help are just as important. So I think that in my career, my whole job has been to strike the balance between what the police want, the victims want, the, you know, the accused wants, the accused families want, the victim, you know, there's all of these things. I have to take them all into consideration, then do what is the right thing for everybody. And I think economically you have to do that. And I think with the programming, you have to do it as well.
Excellent. Thank you for sharing your thoughts with us today, Ramona.
Well, thank you for asking me.